Welcome back, friends. In this demo, we're going to be looking at another cool JSON solution. This one is going to be an announcements solution. Now, normally these will require custom development. It'll require SharePoint framework or something similar to that. It would require a developer, basically. This one is totally different. This is using list JSON formatting, so just a regular list item rendered on a screen in a really cool way. Let's jump into this solution that I found on the PNP GitHub repo. Now, to start setting this up, the first thing we're going to have to do is build a list for the backend. In the documentation, they list all the columns that are needed for this particular formatting block. So I'm going to add the columns according to that. You could use a content type with this, but for now, I'm just going to add it to the default list content type. And these text labels don't necessarily mean errors, success, info, warning. That's just what they were referred to here, and they correspond to items inside the JSON formatting. You could rename these as long as you also update the JSON to reflect those new values. Remove date is going to be the date that this announcement should come down. And this is going to be an optional picture that could be displayed on the right-hand side after the announcement. And now I'm just going to add in a few list items so that we can see what we're working with. Okay, we've got our list items created. Let's work on the view. So we'll start by creating a custom view just for this formatting so that we can still easily access these list items and edit them. It'll be a public view. And then we'll go back in here to format this. For the formatting, we're going to be clicking on the JSON file in this solution. And now let's just take a moment to talk about what this JSON is. This isn't that complex. I know it may look that, but trust me, you can get this. If you've got some basic HTML knowledge, then you'll recognize what they're kind of doing here. You'll see that there's a div that is being created. And under here where it says style, you'll see that it's setting different CSS properties. One is the display property. Here you'll see that if the remove date is in the past compared to now, then it's not going to display anything. It'll set that display property to none. And if you're familiar with CSS, you'll know that that hides the element. So this won't even render if the date has passed. That's how the remove date field works on here. You'll see other options here, like here's where the image tag is being added. And if we scroll down, you'll start to see where all of the rest of our data is being rendered on the screen. The background color that indicates the status, and down here, you'll see the title and description being added as well. This is a great example to start to look through and understand how these JSON formatting blocks will work. Once you can understand how these things work, you can open up a more complex one and even understand that and start to make changes to it. Now let's copy this JSON in. We're going to go to the right and hit the copy raw file button. Then back into our solution, hit advanced mode so we can see the JSON, delete everything that's in here, and just paste in that code. You could hit preview just to make sure it looks okay. We'll save this and close the pane. So that looks really cool. Probably chose the wrong icon and color for that open enrollment. So let's go back and fix that list item. We'll just change this to the green one. Now let's recheck the announcements. That looks better. So let's set this up on our homepage. for this, all we'll have to do is jump into edit mode, add in a new list web part. We'll pick our announcements, edit this web part, and we're going to change the view to announcements. And then we can hide the command bar to clean things up a little bit. And there we go. That looks really cool. And if we hover over this, you see that the picture is actually broken. It could be something that's just changed with how SharePoint stores data. So I've debugged this offline and I'll show you how to fix this error. First, we're going to go back into our JSON formatting. And from here, we're going to find that place we saw earlier that stores the image. That's right here. And we're going to add in period server relative URL. What was happening was image hover was coming back as an object instead of just a path to an image. So to get the actual image path, which is what we need for that image tag, we need to add in the dot server relative URL, which will give us the URL to the image. That's what the image tag needs. So let's save this, close this, and we'll go back to the home page and refresh it and see if that works. And now the image is working. Now, maybe it's just my browser that's hating me today because it knows I'm doing a demo, or this hover is a little bit quirky. It took quite a while to get this hover to come up. I don't know why, so if you're having issues with this too, well then I would just recommend taking the hover out of there, deleting any of the references to that image hover column, and using this with no hover effect. I think it'll be just fine. But in any case, at least we've got this image working. From this point, you could start to customize this thing any way you want. Take it step by step, making a little change to that JSON and then checking the results on the page. That way, if you screw something up, like I do, then you can just do a Control Z to undo that. You could probably hit the cancel button too, for that matter. And just start updating this thing to make it your own, make it unique to your organization. But this gives you an outstanding starting point for creating something without writing a single line of JavaScript or TypeScript. I hope you've enjoyed this demo. I think this is a really cool, simple option to add to your environment. Let me know what you think down in the comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to the channel to keep up with all my latest content.